Hi, welcome. I'm Kate of the Hip Girls Guide to Homemaking book and blog. The blog is hipgirlshome.com. So today we're going to make marmalade. Meyer lemons are in season right now. It's winter. This is probably my favorite winter citrus. Meyer lemons are a cross between a mandarin orange and a lemon. Meyer lemons are sweeter than a traditional lemon, and you can eat the whole rind and all, which makes them perfect for a marmalade. Now, I know what you're thinking, marmalade, scary, but no, canning projects can be intimidating to beginners. Marmalade is an excellent place to start for a couple reasons. First of all, it's an overnight recipe, which means you get some time. You prepare the fruit the first night, and then you're done. You put everything away, do your dishes, go to bed, check your email, do whatever you need to do. The next night, you actually make the marmalade. So what you're doing is you're spreading out the work, which makes the marmalade better and you less stressed out. So great. Last month, I made a traditional Meyer lemon marmalade, which is just Meyer lemons, sugar, and water. This month, I've hoarded more citrus and we're gonna make another batch together today. I'm gonna show you all the steps and show you how not hard it really is. I've also decided, I've made an executive decision, that we're gonna use some star anise. Step one, in our recipe, I know from looking at our recipe that we're gonna process our jars for 5 minutes, which means that's not long enough to sterilize the jar itself. So we need to start out by sterilizing the jar. So if you're using one of your normal home stock pots, you can use a cake rack or whatever fits inside the bottom. I have many different sizes on hand, so I could actually can a very short jar in even a pot like this because it fits nicely. So right now we're gonna put our jars. We need about 9 jars. So that actually fits in my home stock pot with the water covering it. So that's really cool. So I'm gonna put the jar. These are regular kitchen tongs. If you buy a canner kit, which is about $10, you'll get a pair of these. They both work great. These are great for the bigger pint-sized jars, like that. Thank you, Star Anise. So, we're gonna put your jar in the water. You probably can't see this right now, but the exact rims of my jars are just touching the water. So what I'm gonna do is put that on to boil before we start cooking our fruit. So, there we go. So now that our jars are in the process of being sterilized, which they're just gonna boil until we're ready to fill them. That's all that they're doing, which makes it better because then they're hot and they're sterilized. So last night I cut up my lemons and I added water and I let it sit in the fridge. So today I just simmered them so that the rinds are soft and tender, which took about 5 minutes. Now I'm about to add sugar. And you think that this sounds like a ton of sugar, which it is, but if you think about it, a marmalade is really just like a jelly with chunks of the rind suspended in it. I've picked out 3 whole star anise, and I'm gonna just throw them in. The bud of the star anise itself is actually the most flavorful part, so I'm gonna let that just steep and simmer as we cook our marmalade. So now that we have all our ingredients in, we're going to put the heat on medium and let that sugar dissolve. And the way you know it's dissolved is when you push your spoon along the bottom, you don't feel any more granules. So once that's dissolved, make sure my heat, all right. Once that's fully dissolved, then we're gonna turn the heat up on high and cook. While I'm waiting for my marmalade to come to a boil, I can start to show you some of the other things we'll be using today. I already showed you the official jar lifter if you don't feel confident with the kitchen tongs. Another thing you're going to need if you pursue canning is a basic kitchen scale. This one's a little bit fancier, but I use it pretty much almost every day during the height of canning season. So I really like it. I like how you can put different size things on it. You're also gonna be using jars, obviously. And if you start to reuse your jars, you're gonna need to buy some spare lids. You can only use the lids once because they have this special gummy stuff right here. And once you use it, that gummy seal weakens. And so you're gonna need to get a pack of these lids. You wanna make sure and feel around to make sure that there are no chips around the rim, just right in here, because any chip will cause that gummy seal not to attach properly, and you might not get a seal. So let's check on this. The sugar has fully dissolved, and I'm bringing the marmalade to a boil right now. It's also of note that in the fruit preparation, I'm gonna bring this forward without making too big of a mess here. In the fruit preparation, I put the seeds from the Meyer lemons in this tea ball. The seeds help with added pectin in your cooking. Another thing that's gonna be really helpful as you're learning to can is to get a thermometer. This is probably my favorite solution to the problem, because if you have a regular poke stick thermometer or even a jelly thermometer, you're gonna burn yourself trying to get that thing, trying to get a good reading. The reason I like this one is because this whole cord goes directly into the pot. You don't have to be anywhere near it to get a good reading. This thermometer is about $14, so you don't have to get anything very fancy. And this has been my favorite recent addition to my canning kitchen. This is the rim that goes on top of the lid when you're sealing your jar. So I've found that putting these in individually can drive a person crazy trying to get them out. I've tied a piece of kitchen twine around them because I was tired of fishing around in the bottom rack of my canner. So here they go. Bye. My marmalade's just starting to boil, and I want to talk about bubbles. You're going to see a frenzy of small bubbles. As it approaches the gel stage, the bubbles are going to change. You're going to see dime-sized bubbles, which are much larger than those initial ones that you first saw when it just started to boil. And the dime-sized bubbles are going to be spread all around the pot pretty evenly. I'm making sure to stir the probe around to all areas of the pot. And the reading here is 220. The reading where I just was 219. It's a kind of tricky scenario, but keeping it on as you stir will help you to start see when your marmalade has gelled. So if you see these large bubbles, they're different from in the beginning. We still have some smaller ones, but the general bubble consistency around your pot is much larger. And they're a little darker. When you think your marmalade has set, you always want to remove it from the heat because you don't want it to keep cooking. Sometimes it can be kind of scary to pull jars out of a vat of boiling water, understandably. So I really love to use my kitchen gloves, which have a water stop feature on them. I would never reach inside the boiling water, but it helps to prevent burns from splashes and whatnot. So this is a good point to put these on because they're still maneuverable and you can still grab things. So we're gonna pull out our jars and get them ready to fill them up with our delicious marmalade. Once you measured a 220 degrees Fahrenheit thermometer reading from various places around your pot, you've removed your pan from the heat, and now you're not gonna mess with it too much because that could affect the gelling bonds. You don't wanna be stirring or doing anything else. You just kinda wanna leave it alone. Now it's time to put your marmalade in jars. It sat for about 5 minutes at rest, giving it time to relax. your marmalade pot's gonna be really hot. So if you're not wearing gloves, just be very careful. So you want to scoop juice and rind together to get an even amount in the jar. Now I'm lifting my funnel to show you what headspace is. So I'd say that that's about a half an inch headspace. You want for a marmalade anywhere between a half and a quarter inch headspace. I'm happy with that. So I'm gonna keep going. The reason you wanna stick with the right amount of headspace on a jar is because if there's too much air and space between your marmalade and the top of the lid, it could affect your seal. Our lids are at a perfect simmer. So what we're gonna do now is take a clean, like you haven't used it before for any other areas of the kitchen, just out of the washing, a clean towel or a paper towel. And you're gonna wanna just dip it a little bit in your lid saucepan. So what we want to do is make sure that the rims of these jars are free from syrup so that the gummy seal on, we're gonna wanna make sure these jars are free from syrup around the edges and the rims, because then the gummy seal can affix itself properly and you're gonna get to hear that cool pinging noise. So I'm gonna untie these. This is a good opportunity to talk about these as well. If you bought a canning kit, this is called a bubbler, and it comes with a standard ball canning kit. You'll wanna look around, and sometimes with other things, you'll need to bubble. You know, our marmalade is very fluid, so there aren't air bubbles trapped in here. But a chopstick also works very well for bubbling. You wanna bubble your jars like so, for the same reason you wanna ensure adequate headspace, so that no extra air sneaks its way into the jar and affects your seal. Today I actually forgot my magnet, so I'm gonna use my kitchen tongs again to place the lid on the jar. You're going to screw the band on, and the jar is gonna be hot. So you wanna make sure you don't burn your fingers. But when you put the band on, finger tight means you don't need to use your whole arm in the motion. So it's as tight as you can get it by just turning it with your fingers and not burning your hand on the bottom. So now we've put on all of the lids and bands, and now it's time to put them all in the canner pot, which has been boiling away while we sealed our jars. So I hear the bubbles starting up in there. You can always peek to see if you see bubbles actually boiling through. I'm gonna set my timer for 5 minutes. Once that's up, we're gonna take our jars out. So I'm gonna set this up in advance. You want a kitchen towel, something absorbent for when you pull out your jars. So I'm all ready. The pinging's gonna start happening, but we'll be extra quiet so we can hear them. Now that wasn't so bad, was it? This marmalade can be used in so many ways around the kitchen. You can put it on toast, on muffins, dollop it in yogurt, over ice cream. You can even put it over chicken or fish or pork to add a really interesting flavor to your dish. Thanks.